This is how Jesus the Messiah was born.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph from the family of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said,
"The Lord has given you a special favor. He is with you." Mary was very upset because of his words. She wondered what kind of greeting this could be. But the angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you.
You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord will make him a king like his father David of long ago. He will rule forever over his people who came from Jacob's family. His kingdom will never end."
"How could this happen, Mary?" asked the angel. "I am a virgin."
The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come to you. The power of the Most High God will cover you. So the Holy One that is born will be called the Son of God."
"I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it happen to me just as you say it would." Then the angel left her.
While she was still a virgin, she became pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit. Her soon-to-be husband, Joseph, was a godly man. He did not want to put her to shame in public, so he decided to break the engagement quietly.
But as Joseph was thinking about this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. The angel said,
"Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary home as your wife. The baby inside of her is from the Holy Spirit. She is going to have a son, and you are going to name him Jesus."
"That is because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to bring about what the Lord had said would happen. He had said through the prophet Isaiah,
"The virgin is going to have a baby. She will give birth to a son, and he will be called Emmanuel." The name Emmanuel means God with us.
Joseph woke up. He did what the angel of the Lord commanded him to do. He took Mary home as his wife. In those days, Caesar Augustus made a law. It required that a list be made of everyone in the whole Roman world. All went to their own towns to be listed.
So Joseph went from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem because he belonged to the family line of David. Mary and Joseph went as required, even though she was about to give birth.
While Joseph and Mary were there, the time came for the child to be born. She wrapped him in snuggly strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them.
And Joseph named him Jesus.
There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby. It was night and they were looking after their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. It is for all the people today in the town of David a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Here is how you will know I am telling you the truth. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a large group of angels from heaven also appeared. They were praising God. They said,
"Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased."
The angels left and went into heaven. Then the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. The baby was lying in a manger, just as the angels had said to them. After the shepherds had seen him, they told everyone. They reported what the angel had said about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary kept all these things like a secret treasure in her heart. She thought about them over and over.
As the shepherds returned to their sheep, they gave glory and praise to God. Everything they had seen and heard was just as they had been told.
After Jesus' birth, the wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the child who has been born to be king of the Jews? When we were in the east, we saw his star. Now we have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard about it, he was very upset because he didn't want there to be another king. Everyone in Jerusalem was troubled too. So Herod called together all the chief priests of the people. He also called the teachers of the law. He asked them where the Christ was going to be born.
The prophet Micah said, "In Bethlehem in Judea." They replied, "This is what the prophet has written. He said,
but you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are certainly not the least important among the towns of Judah. A ruler will come out to you. He will be the shepherd of my people, Israel."
Then Herod called for the wise men secretly. He found out from them exactly where the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem. He said,
"Go and make careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, bring me a report. Well, then I can go and worship him too."
After the wise men had listened to the king, they went on their way. The star they had seen when they were in the east went ahead of them. It finally stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
The wise men went to the house where they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down to him and worshiped him. They opened their treasures. They gave him gold, incense, and myrrh.
This is the telling of the birth of Jesus, our Savior.